Hello everyone, this video classic deployment of Sitefinity application with PowerShell to Azure is part of how-to series about Sitefinity and Azure. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the classic deployment approach to upload your Sitefinity web app and database to Azure using app services. I already set up an SQL server and Redis cache in the online portal. To use the Azure Management API, we need a certificate. Microsoft provides more information on their documentation website how to generate it. You could find a link in the description of the video too. For the purpose of this demo, I'm going to use the PowerShell script in order to create it. The script generates two certificates. To use the API, you have to upload the certificate in the Azure portal. The caveat here is that you have to log in the classic version of the portal. Now the file is uploaded and we have to get the publish settings in order to deploy our project. I'll use PowerShell again to do it. By executing the command, we are redirected to the website and the file is automatically downloaded. The next step is to get the PowerShell scripts from the Sitefinity GitHub repo. The publish settings that we downloaded should be pasted and renamed to subscription1.publishSettings in the cloud configs folder, because the scripts are looking for that particular file name. Those settings should be set also in the Azure subscription data config file. The certificate data should have the same name as the management certificate. The subscription ID should be mapped to ID and the subscription name to name. The deployment label is an open field. The second step is to go to Scripts, Configuration, and set the JSON config file. In the SQL section, we have to put information about our SQL server, server name, which we already created in the portal, the connection string to the database, the username, password, and the location. We can list more than one server and deploy on different locations. For this demo, we will leave only one. Go back to the scripts folder and open a PowerShell as an administrator. Navigate to the scripts and you can use GitHub to find more information for them. To run the script, we have to put a few parameters. The first one is the directory of the website. After this, the name of the local SQL server and the name of the database. The fourth parameter is the name of the website that will be created in the portal. To use the Redis cache, we have to add a param for it too. Otherwise, it's not going to be used. Open the management portal and get the info to compose the value. You can find information for its format in our documentation. Concat the primary key with @ and the address of the connection string and append SSL parameter equal to true. Also, we can set the website location and use the SQL server in that location. Deploy database is set to true by default. In case that you want to make updates only on the website, we should set it to false. The build configuration option is responsible to build the project before deploy, and you have two options, build or release. Release is by default. When launch website is set to true, a request is made to the website once the deployment is done. The website is up and you can see it in the browser. Let's open the Azure portal and assure that the app and the database are there. If you are interested for more details about Sitefinity and Azure, please watch the rest of the videos from the playlist.